Right-wing megachurch pastor Robert Jeffress is a man who once compared President Barack Obama to the Antichrist. In fact, he had said that Obama and the LGBT community were working together to usher in the era of the Antichrist. This week, after the shootings in Alexandria, Robert Jeffress came out and said, "We've got to watch this violent, angry rhetoric coming from the left. Because it's the left's fault. Anytime something happens, right?" Yeah, the guy who went and shot the two congressmen was a liberal. He was a Bernie Sanders supporter, worked on Bernie Sanders' campaign as a volunteer. He subscribed to a lot of progressive media outlets on his Facebook page, including Ring of Fire. We do not condone his actions. We have never encouraged his actions. And we will, you know, never encourage violence against anyone. But Robert Jeffress, do you not see the problem here? Since this shooting took place, Republicans of all kinds have come out and immediately blame the left. They say it's the violent rhetoric coming from the left. Now, I haven't necessarily seen violent rhetoric from the left. I've seen angry rhetoric. I've also seen very true rhetoric. When we call out Republicans for their disastrous health care bill that's going to strip 23 million Americans of their health insurance, that's not inciting violence. That's telling the truth. Something that journalists in this country used to do. But Republicans in the Senate won't even let us see their version of the healthcare bill. That's not inciting violence. That's telling the truth. And that's where Republicans seem to have a real problem today. They can't separate angry rhetoric with truth telling. Because if you want to talk about angry rhetoric, how about we talk about when Alex Jones was pumping the Pizzagate conspiracy that inspired a right-wing nut job to go into a pizza parlor and start shooting it up. Yeah, about a month later, he came out and apologized for it finally, but we see things like that happen all the time. Dylann Roof, where was the calls to tone down the anti-black community rhetoric from Republicans, huh? Anytime a police officer kills an unarmed black man, do Republicans go out there and say that police officers need to tone down the violence? No! They jump on their side and say blue lives matter. They do matter, but there's also a problem in there. Anytime Republicans get the opportunity to blame something on the left, it's like the entire history of the United States never happened. They don't have to be introspective and look at themselves and all of the violence that they have inspired over the years. No, they see a window of opportunity to blame something on Bernie Sanders or his supporters or the entire left in general, and they jump on it. And this is disgusting what they're doing right now. Violent rhetoric in the United States is a problem, absolutely. And there are plenty of psychopaths on the left and the right. But the left is not the big problem here. The majority of this anti-establishment, anti-DC rhetoric is coming from the Republicans. Hell, Ted Nugent himself suggested that it would be great if he could go kill Barack Obama and Hillary Clinton. And yeah, since this shooting, he's come out and said, well, you know, I guess we need to tone it down a bit. Yeah, after calling for the murders of the president and the secretary of state, maybe you should tone it down a bit. But I have never seen rhetoric like that come out of anyone on the left. And for the right to suggest anything otherwise is an absolute lie. And as always, we're going to keep pointing out those lies. And you may think that that's angry rhetoric, but most of us in this country would just consider that telling the truth. If you like this video, make sure that you like, comment, and share, and most importantly, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you want to help support Ring of Fire, go to patreon.com/theringoffire, become a monthly patron to help support independent progressive media.